number of unclaimed bodies in Kansas is on the rise, and now that the state has cut a program to help poor families bury their loved ones, KMBC 9's Micheal Mahoney is live.
Well, it does not happen that often, but once in a while, there is no one to claim a body. The state used to have some money to take care of the arrangements, but not anymore.
The money to assist in taking care of the unclaimed remains, as they're called, was eliminated because the state budget's so tight.
We don't have anything to fall back on at all.
Greg Amos of the Amos Funeral Home Company. Now, the state used to pay $550 to help bury the unclaimed dead. The executive director of the Kansas Funeral Directors Association, Pam Scott, says there were 1,194 unclaimed bodies in the state last year, but the number of unclaimed cases is lower than that because sometimes organizations like the Veterans Administration will step up and take care of their own. Now the counties are responsible.
For people that don't have any family or don't have any money to handle this, it used to be that there was something available. It wasn't much, but it was something.
Amos says cemeteries are now often reluctant to donate a grave or open one up for free, so many of the unclaimed bodies are cremated, and that requires someone to authorize a very final act.
You can always dig a body up if a family member comes up and wants something. After cremation's done, there's no remorse. I mean, it's over.
Scott from the Funeral Directors Association says there are 105 counties in Kansas. Almost every one handles this problem differently.
And it is very unlikely, she says, that the $500,000 the state used to set aside for the unclaimed bodies will be restored in the immediate future. Bye.
All right, Michael, thank you. Well, this issue has sparked some heated debate on our Facebook page. Mike Smith wrote, "When are people going to start taking responsibility for their own lives instead of expecting the government to bail them out every time they make poor financial choices?" And Stephanie McInerney says, "I would be more than willing for my tax dollars to go toward this program."